Your Majesty, Emperor and Royal King, Tiburcio Villamor Marcos Talano Talilan IV, could you please elucidate why you are the ex-officio chairman of the Federal Reserve System in the United States of America?
The former Federal Reserve System, there are actually 12, have the last one that has been deposited with 80,000 metric ton actually that come from our country. Again, 80,000 metric ton that was then Fort Knox. Have the corresponding bank, the liaison bank, and the conduit bank is actually Citibank. Have not only that, I serve with the Federal Reserve as an incognito major key chairman of the Federal Reserve System because of the gold that we deposited at the 12, 13 Federal Reserve Treasury Vault. I'm referring now to the Federal Reserve Bank of New York, Federal Reserve Bank of Kansas, Missouri, Federal Reserve Bank of Massachusetts, Federal Reserve Bank of Virginia, Federal Reserve Bank of Florida, Federal Reserve Bank of Pennsylvania, Federal Reserve Bank of Chicago, Federal Reserve Bank of Massachusetts, and to name you all of them. The last one was Federal Reserve Bank of Fort Knox.
So how many metric tons of gold are there in your 13 treasury vaults in the Federal Reserve?
Through which include now the documented gold no lifting, or probably through documentary we have today within the tune of the 10 million metric ton of gold. Make no mistake, the Federal Reserve today system, Treasury, is our Millennium Centurion Gold Bullion Bank of the world. I will be serving, which I serve now, as a chairman of the Monetary Board of the Board of Governor or Presidents of the 13th Federal Reserve System. I'm also the person behind the Global Funder Death Facility. So, in short, we are the bankroller. I am the successor heir, sole signatory, and judicial administrator of the the 13th Federal Reserve Treasury Systems Board or Vault. I serve again as the chairman of the board of trustees, board of governors, presidents, of the Federal Reserve System, serving as a chairman of the Monetary Board, of the Board of Governors.
So, the Federal Reserve System is located in Washington, District of Columbia. Is it true that the Federal Reserve System is a privately owned corporation? If so, who is the owner of that corporation?
Make no mistake, there are people that becomes as board members or my bankers. They serve as my directors. But look, they are the Swift, the Morgans, the Rothschild, the Rockefellers, the Brandines. But look, they are not the owners of the Federal Reserve Treasury deposits of gold. This is owned by the king, king of recognized asset nations. And I share this to all 110 million Filipinos. We are the bankrollers of the Federal Reserve Treasury System, Treasury Board. We are, again, the Millennium Centurion Gold Bullion Bank of the world. Again, I hope you will understand. There is a saying, whoever had the ownership, the signatory of the global asset, especially the gold, makes the rule. And this is the golden rule. Thank you.
So, you showed me a bundle of $100 million bills. Each one is worth $1 million bill. So why you have that currency, Your Majesty? Is that specially issued to you only?
This bill, the 100,000...
100 million.
Or 100 million
bundle.
Federal Reserve bonds, or they could be JP Morgan, Wells Fargo. These are all our receipts. Receipts from one of the treaties, the Treaty of Versailles, actually. The Treaty of Versailles are Federal Reserve bonds and Federal Reserve notes. But these are only receipts that we had.
So how can you use the Federal Reserve System in bankrolling the world in connection with the reactivated Central Bank of the Philippines, which is more functional, the Central Bank of the Philippines or the Federal Reserve System in bankrolling the world?
Actually, the Central Bank of the Philippines is a conduit. Perhaps it's just one of the safekeeping bank, but the Central Bank of the Philippines is actually merged. The asset that we have here, which include the undocumented gold and the ancestral eminent domain of Hacienda Filipina Archipelago will be the OCT T01-4 will be bolted at the same time at the Federal Reserve Treasury Bolt. As such, it's now the Federal Reserve System Treasury that serves as our Millennium Centurion Gold Bullion Bank of the World.
So, which has a great gold reserves, the Central Bank of the Philippines or the Federal Reserve System?
Of course, the Federal Reserve System is privately owned now. And we are the major gold bullion bank. To name it, probably cartel of the world.
So, which is more important for you, the Central Bank of the Philippines or the Federal Reserve System?
Of course, it will be the Federal Reserve Treasury Bolt. Jiro, we have the assets now deposited officially and legally, agreed, amended with ministerial and diplomatic agreements with all kinds of gents, insured and bonded with a title insurance coverages or policy for that matter.
So, is it true that the United States of America is bankrupt right now? And why?
If the asset of the king of recognized asset nation will not be able to back up the U.S. Treasury, the U.S. dollars by itself, then they're only using a bubble derivative fiat currency. You cannot use a fiat currency because these are considered to be Mickey Mouse or just plain paper money. No value. Make no mistake. This has to be guaranteed. It has been already agreed by the whole world. We have to use gold, diamond, platinum, and silver to back up our monetary system to have value. Or otherwise, we'll just be working on a hype, we'll just be reinventing all kinds of scams and schemes. And if we'll not back up with gold or precious metals, believe me, it will be a whole disaster to the whole world. Then everybody will be printing money. Would you like to do that? Perhaps. No? But listen, why will a printing house that prints newspaper or books, they might as well just print money, because there will be no rules and there will be no backup. There are no guarantees. Make no mistake, we'll make this work for all of us and for the whole world. Perhaps, if we have to do so, We have the backing. The answer of the king of recognized Azad nations. We have the gold that will back up our monetary system of central banks of central banks. Let it be if we have to use Nasara law or Jesara law, so be it. We'll make this work for all of us and to the whole world and for the good of everybody and for the good of humanity.
That's a highly informative answer, Your Majesty. You directed the U.S. government about the visa waiver program for Filipinos. So, can you enforce your directive to the U.S. government to allow the Filipinos to enter the United States without visa for at least for a maximum of 6 months? Can you direct the U.S. government to enforce your directive about the visa waiver program for Filipinos? Because Filipinos are indeed the bankrollers of the United States of America.
This has been lobbied to Congress, or I don't know if I have to call the congressman and senators Blue Ribbon Committee in the United States. But please get involved with the monetary system. More so, I'm only asking that Filipinos, you have to open up also. Do not make rules with us. You Americans, you come in the Philippines. You don't need a visa. But when a Filipino come to United States, you make them like a fool. So, please, to all of you in Congress, congressmen, senators, put up a proviso, a bill. Let Filipinos come. Open up your borders to Filipinos, because we are bankrolling the U.S. Treasury. We're trying our best to make the U.S. dollars the dominant currency. I only follow the founding fathers of the U.S. government, because these are their visions to use this asset of the king of recognized asset nation. This is the global death facility that I have. And I'm ready, willing, and able to back up the Federal Reserve Treasury's vault, so that we'll be able to have a new beginning. And this will now make the U.S. government the strongest nation in the world.
So, what can you say about the scheduled monetary reset this month of August? Will there be a bankruptcy, or the demonetization of currencies? Well, could you please explain further?
Again, everybody's learned today. You can no longer fool everyone. especially the Securities and Exchange Commission, the NASDAQ, the AMEX. Listen, it's all hype. You cannot sell us stocks with no value. But then, as I've said, it's a derivative. There are only few people that are talking, then so sudden they float the price. Nobody's buying. Who's a fool today that will buy a stock that doesn't have any value? Definitely. It will collapse. It's a bankrupt system. You can no longer fool investors today. At the heart of the Americas, I see that almost like about 95% of the population are really hand to mouth, right at the heart of the US government. We understood that. But 85% of the population are receiving social welfare administration. They're falling in line. We don't have enough research. My understanding, the government has like about 37 trillion of deficit or owing all over the world. Will definitely will collapse, and it's now completely bankrupt. You cannot just print money, because that's a Mickey Mouse or plain paper money that will not have a value.
So what will happen when it collapses? What? For example, in the Philippines, specifically speaking, what will happen? Can you now enter the Banco Central of the Philippines when the currency collapses?
Well, I have no idea, because it's a practice here that there are no rules. You can just print money here now in the Philippines. And I'm hoping that none of this other printing press, instead of printing newspapers or books, they probably is printing already money. Because here in the Philippines, there are no rules now that I have observed.
So what you gonna do to enforce the Alpha Omega rules in printing money?
Well, then this is a global problem. That was the reason why we have the United Nations Security Council, Project ECOSOC, the embodiment then of social, economic, educational, and political embodiment of the global economic development. Infrastructure. We're trying to back up all the central banks. As I've said, I just mentioned earlier, there is a Nazara law or Gezara law that could possibly be our total mechanism for that purpose, and it will be a form of a governance.
May I know your special message to your distant relative, United States President Donald John Trump, before we end this interview?
Well, my beloved President Donald J. Trump, my understanding, you are my relative. We're both come from the Habsburg, because we are both Macleod. Listen, I've been observing you for the past 3 years of your incumbency as a president of the United States. You don't have even the courtesy to call me now. You need me. Because if you don't, believe me, you will not succeed. Only the usher of the king of recognized asset nation can help you.
That's an emphatic message, Your Majesty. Thank you very much. And we hope that the U.S. government will heed to your directive regarding the U.S. visa waiver program for Filipinos. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Again, we have all the blessings of the Lord Jesus, God Allah, Jehovah.